Blub blub everyone, welcome to Lords and Villains. This is a nice economy builder in a way. It's a colony simulation like RimWorld without the combat, without... Well, it's actually not that much like RimWorld, but the style is, the art style is. It has a really nice style, and let's just jump into it and we'll see what it's all about. Actually, I don't know where we should start. Any preferences in chat? We're streaming this on Twitch at the moment, so if there's anything coming up, you know why. What's with the E? Apparently, this is very old English and just means villagers. But it is the root of the word villain, the newer one. You want mountains, seaside. Okay, you're very... You're very agreeing with each other. It's great, and this was actually the word villains. However you say that, I don't even know if that's correct. How I speak, but apparently just meant the serfs in olden times, and villain is just, well, the lords always thought the villagers are dumb people who are just up to no good and stuff. We must build a mountain fortress for dwarves. We can't even. There's no mountain fortress in here. I just want to drown people. People won't drown in this game. It's actually very peaceful. They'll starve to death. Yes, but they're not gonna drown. There isn't even hunting in the game. I choose seaside tuna. I mean, I don't care. It means a lot of fish. So. I'm Gary the Lord. Well, let's give us a nice little title. I'm the Grandmaster, why not? Gary the Gamerid. Is that how we shall look? Maybe we could randomize a bit. And see if something more interesting comes up. Don't want to be female much. Let's just face forward. I don't know, let's go with this guy. Not going with the... That's very, very cheerful. Let's go with this cape, I like this one. Do we have a beard? Yes, please, I wanna have a beard. Doesn't look like much, though. Well, that's okay. Let's take this little guy. We are young. We are interested in females. I think we should start with a partner. No children, though. Because that just... Without a partner, it's a little harder because we are not able to do as much. Because in here, everyone, children, their parents, uncles, whatever, they all work in their job. They all have live in the same house or the same household, and they all work at the jobs. And the more you have, the better it is, because the more you can produce. Starving is so much more peaceful. This Gary has a big forehead. Does he? I think it's fine. Gary the Lord of Reed. We're the Grandmaster for now. We are still under the king, so we have to pay taxes sooner or later. This is one part of the game that's that makes it challenging. Let's see. I never played Seaside. Just played the tutorial map, so... Grandmaster Gary Gamerid, I have bestowed upon you the right to rule over this land. I expect you to take a great care of exploiting this land and the richness it has to offer. Should you not succeed, I shall find someone else to take your place. And your head as well. Not everyone gets the same opportunity as you, so keep that in mind. By confirming, you shall certify your oath of fealty. Best of luck on your journey. Unfortunately, you cannot rebel against the king. That would have been quite fun. Interesting that we have a major mountain in between us and the sea. And there's a lot of woods, that's good. Oh my god, the maps are so small. I wish the maps would be doubly as big. Because that's quite small. Even more with this big mountain. We need to get rid of this mountain. Okay, but interesting. We got some farmland here and there. We got some forest, which is great because we need forests. Not as much of a forest, though. could be quite challenging because forests are majorly important, as you might know. So that's me. That's my wife, who doesn't have the right name. There it is. Not Clazalo, Clazali, there it is. Now she has the right name. We have a family of farmers and we have a family of foragers. Foragers are the guys who provide us with wood. Farmers provide us with food. And the farmers are very small. Oh, that's a small family. That's really bad. And you are very small. Oh my god, that's really bad. you need to get going with your children. That's just not going to be good for us. Seaside mountain for the win. Yeah, I hope so. I hope so. We need miners to get rid of this mountain. Farming. You have farming skill and everyone has some cooking skill. What's our skill? Our skill is leadership and financing and cooking. And our dear wife has leadership and cooking. Good. My cooking skill is ridiculously bad. I have a hood though. Interesting. I have 3 excellent meals. Well, that's good. I mean, I'm the lord after all. And not a stupid peasant. Should we... We could rename the families after you guys. I think that's something. Mia wanted to be the cheesemaker. So this will be the Mia Liab family. Manaway said something what she wants to be. No, she said just for the XCOM thing, right? So let this be the Fox family. Change family name. Let's do the Lucy Fox family. Librarian or something? why didn't that work? Oh, I didn't. Oh, damn it. Okay, I need to confirm this for some reason. Why pressing enter doesn't work is beyond me, but okay. There you go. So now the families are different. Perfect. Differently named. I won't rename the individual person, I think. Or maybe we could. Maybe we shouldn't rename the families, but the person. But the family will be there for longer than the person, of course. I don't know. What do you prefer, guys? Yay, I have a family. Yes, you do. Okay, we could do something different. Wait a second. Let's do that again. Let this be the Liab family and you are Mir. You are beautiful, Mir. I'm so happy. You have your nice wife called Mary. That's great. And this will be the Fox family. And Lucy, actually, you're married into this family, but that's fine. You'll be the wife. And your dear husband is Gilbert Fox. I mean, okay. I actually like that the people in the forest will be the Fox family. Family sounds good. So the Waschbär family, what kind of family would you like to be? What profession would you like to take? So this game... Well, you think about that. This game is all about zoning. And that's a very interesting aspect. So we can have very different zones, a lot of them, as you can see. There was a patch just recently, just yesterday, I think, that changed some stuff, which is nice. You can see we have miners, masonry, furnace workers, butchers, tanners. We can make some public areas, some marketplaces, a warehouse is for us. This is actually our warehouse with all our wares in it. Just this, all this stuff you can see here is just owned by the Gamerit family. The Waschbärs don't know cooking, making cheesecake. You could be a baker, for example. Baker family, we'll have to keep that in mind. Or maybe butchers or something, that is as close as you can get to cooking. Okay, we'll see. So we have to plan some stuff out. For example, our manor. Let's just put the manor in here. Let's make it quite big. Let's make it an odd number. 9 by 9? 4, 4, 5. Yes, it should be 9 by 9. And let's make a nice, opulent room to sleep in, because, well, we deserve it, of course. And it should be 7x7. There you go. So that's our stuff for, at first. We could make another one. Like here. That is... Unfortunately, it still doesn't show how many tiles that is. 2, 4, 6, 7. 2, 4, 6, 8. No, 7. There we go. So we have two smaller rooms and a big common room. So one for me and my wife and one for our children later when we get some. So that's done for now. Now you can see this is just a zone. This zone is automatically ours because there's only one lord and this is the manor. It can only be owned by the lord. But there's nothing on it. That's just the land that I set aside for myself to be worked on in any way whatsoever. This is not working. This is just the household that I declared for myself. This is the warehouse that I own. The warehouse zone, which I can do whatever I want with. So I can put stores in there. I can make walls if I want. I can, you know, make a real warehouse out of this. And now there are other zones. There are households, generally households, that can be used by peasants. And there is something like farmlands, like the whole royal forests, which we are zoning as their workplace. So let's just make this into the royal forest for now. And since this is their workplace, I probably want them to be up here. We don't have that many woods, so I don't want to block everything here. This would be another good royal forest. We can make this bigger when they grow, because at the moment they can't even work this, I think. This could be farmland, though. I'm contemplating where we should put them. Their household. I guess up here. It'll give them some travel time to come down here, which we will have a marketplace in, I think. I think this would be a nice marketplace here. Let's say like this. Just planning it out. We could have a public area down here too. Close to the marketplace. Public area is for something like public wells and something. Okay. At first, we are just going to plan some stuff. Let's put the household up here. We won't make it too big, I think. Let's just say that's 6. 5x5 is too small. 7x7? I think 7x7 will be fine. Let's give him some very small place to sleep. It's 5x5 and another 5x5 for children later to have something to do there. The farmers, I think we'll put them here. Not too close to us because they're sticky peasants and we don't want to, you know, don't want to have them too close to us. There we go. And let's put one extension of the house here and one here. You can plant them however you want. That's just how I like to do it. There you go. Okay. And there's room to expand. And I think we'll put the farmland in here. Unfortunately, the farmland won't be as big and opulent as I would like. Let's do a 9x4 maybe, and maybe another 9x4. Problem is, we actually need more, but they are so few people right now. We'll extend this when we can. So let's give this land to the Liab family. There are several methods of taxing the people. We can give them the Frankelmoine or whatever that's called taxation, which is just they are free to do whatever they want there. They don't have to pay me anything. They don't owe me anything. Or the fee farm. And that's just they pay me every year, every season, actually. They pay me a certain amount of gold. And let's do that for the moment. And let's give them the farmland here, too. There's more now. There's the fee farm. There's the Frankelmoine, whatever. That means they just can work this land and it's just happening. It's theirs. Everything they gain here is theirs. I can give them stewardry. Stewardry is I pay them and I get 100% of what they do here. So that's the only way I can get everything they have. Well, unless I do sockage at 100%. No, it's not possible. So 75% is the maximum for sockage or sockage or whatever that's called. This stuff means it's like the tenth in the olden times, in the medieval times. So they have to give me a certain percentage of everything they make here at the end of the season. So every season we get taxes. That's tax day. And we get all the money we are owed and we get all the goods we are owed. Let's not do the 10th. Let's give me 30% of everything you make here. And same with this one. Because damn, we need some goods. Okay, so they will work this. I still have to do one more thing. Let's do that. And let's do that. Of course, we need some extra space. And let's say you can do soil farming here. Okay. Oh, we have to do one more. We have to change what they work in here. So barley with the two, and we have one more than a bit of wheat. Let's just say this is a wheat farm up here. We want wheat whenever it's possible. Although we can't plant wheat. Let's give it a priority of 3 for barley. So if you can't plant wheat, plant barley in here. And here, because we need straw. And here we want something to eat, actually. Let's plant some carrots for now. And maybe some tomatoes. Potatoes. Carrots and parsnips is fine. We want a mix. We need a lot of goods, and it's actually pretty bad that there's only 2 people here. We want them to be happy and to make children very soon. Okay, we need to build their houses too, because they won't do it. They are just too dumb. They're just peasants, you know. They just don't. Okay, you up here. This is for the fox family, and you also will give me 30% at least of whatever you make there per season. And this will be your home, not the Liep family, the Fox family. You just give me some gold here. That's fine for the moment. We can change the taxes whenever we want because we are the freaking lord. And they are just peasants. You don't need this or that. The rest you can work. Okay. We need some space outside of the forest because I don't want to block the forest space here. We need some workable buildings too. Okay. Anything else we have to prepare for? No, I don't think so. We can give them some meals, and we probably should. I can grant them... Oh, we only have 400 meals? Oh, that's not much. Let's give the Liaps 50 meals, and let's give the Fox family 50 meals. Because we need to get to a point where we are self-sufficient. We can also sell some stuff. We have some wood. Let's give 40 wood that we can sell at market price, because I want money. And let's get rid of 80 planks at market price. We will need them. We also need to provide some yarn. Let's say all. And whenever people want to buy it, they can. And let's provide 200 straw at market price. Everything at market price because I want money. People are working right now. We can also provide 30 stone. I don't think that will be necessary at the moment, but that's fine. We don't want to provide silk because we need silk ourselves. So, we can build a storefront here. Let's build it in the direction of the marketplace right now. They need space to stand on. You stand here and you sell there. So let's put it here for now. And with the storefront, we can sell our goods. We are not participating in the market, by the way. So that's not a thing. Instead, we just get the taxes. And the peasants are participating in the market. So we can build some storefronts here too. Let's just build it this way. Storefront, storefront, storefront. And I think storefront, storefront, storefront. And this is a shared market. Everyone in our village can go here and just use one of the storefronts and sell their goods. They just need to bring them here first. Oh, we need to get rid of this tree. Okay, people are idle right now. That's not a good thing. Let's build some housing, shall we? So, you'll get some wooden walls. I think I want a door here. And this will be your room where you sleep in. It's very, very cramped, but I mean, you're a peasant, so that's how it goes, right? Don't know why there is no music, unfortunately. Should be one, should be some. Maybe I should extend this a little? Nah, that'll be fine. That's okay. Get some doors, just a wooden door there and there and there, and they'll build this. There is no roof on this at the moment. There is no floor. They are just sleeping on the ground right now, but they'll manage. For now, they'll manage. Let's go here. These guys won't have a problem building their house. They even have more space as it looks like, at least. Did they really give them more space? That can't be. They're peasants. Come on. They don't deserve space. There you go. That is fine. Build some. No, that should be a wooden door there. Thank you. And build a wooden door, I guess, closer to the street. Okay, so that's their buildings for the moment. We should put beds in there. Straw double beds, so that's actually the most important one of them. Because they need to procreate. We need more children. We need more workers. Okay, we can do this too. I could plan our housing here. Let's just do some of that. Just wooden walls for now. We can later upgrade to stone if we want. And we'll probably do want that. Normally, I tend to give the peasants more room. But I mean, they're peasants, right? Let's put this here. And let's put this here. We, of course, get the heavy doors. We deserve nice things. They don't. And if you click on the blueprint, you can also get some stuff you can place. We have the space. Let's do this. And let's get a noble bed for whenever we get some children. There you go. There you go. The children can bunk, of course. Who cares about them? They're children. So beds are very important, so you get some people soon. As you can see at the moment, everyone sleeps in the fields, on the ground, wherever they can. They just have no choice. And you want to be a baker, Vashbe. Okay, I'll try to remember that. Why is there no music? Frequent music. I don't know. Let's hope that there will be some music soon. Ah, that's better. There's some music. Very nice. So we wanna get some miners, because look at this. There is some iron ore in here. There is some limestone in here. That's pretty nice. So we can do a lot of stuff with this. Let's at the moment get rid of these things here. They're just in the way, the trees. Don't even think we get anything out of this, because they're not like the royal forest guys. Ah, there you go. They already have some double beds. We have normal beds and a double bed. Great, so we can make children, and they have a double bed so they can make children. Since they do have that right now, maybe we want to extend this. Even more so since they're farmers, we want to extend their zoning a little bit. Give me a wall, get rid of these. Give me some beds. I really hope I can get them to procreate a bit. Because we need more people in there. There you go. And you, I mean, it's not that important that you have children, but if you can make some, we need some more workers here. We can also give you something to make planks with, which is the sawhorse. Question is, should it be here or should it be up there? I think let's have it here. I also need some storage. Some ground storage. There it is. To keep all the wood in. And they could use some... Actually, that's not in here. That's strange. They could use some barrels too, because they will find some berries. Which we will want to, well, use. We can eat them. We can't cook yet, because to cook, you need several buildings. And I don't want to overwhelm them too much. These guys already have more to do than they should. Why are you planting stuff I don't want? Because wheat is still in there. But it's out of plantable season. Why do you... Oh, you're planting barley right there. Okay, let's get rid of barley too. Didn't see that. I want... No. You made... No, I don't. This. There you go. The royal stamp, of course. Needs to be in there. So to store these things, we want some silos. Silos for grain. Wait, we can see that. When we hover over this. Can keep grains, corn, rice, and hops. Barrels keep vegetables and fruits and fish. And what's the other one? Shelves. Shelves are for meals, so they need that in their homes. They can get animals, but I think that would overwhelm you, Mir. So we don't want that yet, I think. Flailing spot is very important because we need to flail the corn. So we want that. Yeah, and I guess a silo here or two. Let's get two silos for now. And maybe some ground storage. Should I give you a little bit more zoning here? For some ground storage. I'll probably want to give you a warehouse anyway. So yeah, let's plan this to be the warehouse later. Because we want to extend your stuff. Very soon. Yeah, let's just plan the ground storage for now. Just give you some ground storage here. Okay. Later we want to give them a floor, we want to give them a roof. And they have moods, and we need to keep them happy somewhat. Well, you see, not that happy, but... we can see stuff from them which will make them unhappy. We can change their taxes which will make them unhappy. So there's a lot of stuff we could do that would probably not be the best all the time, but we sometimes have to do this. At the moment we have 3 gold, 35 silver and 42 copper. They don't even have stuff to store this in. They need chests too later. We could be mean. We could be really mean. And just give them... No, it's not in here. We could just give them... Storage boxes. Stores mostly gold and basic material, but offers no protection from thieves. So we could do this and they could just rob each other blind. Which would be interesting. So I don't know. Should we do this? Should we make them rob each other until they go literally blind? Hope we get a fisher soon, because that would be really good here. At the sea. Very nice sea. Last time I played in the tutorial, there's a river which you can use. But I guess they just work the same. You were trying to sell stuff. Our forager, okay. Forager tried to sell some wood and no one wanted to buy it. Probably, yeah, they're just busy. They're just busy planting right now. And now they're not busy anymore. That's... So maybe they could handle some more. We can let them tame animals. We just need a farming spot. A farming zone. Farmland. And say you can tame here. Like, through the adjustments, they're animals. We just can say you can have 2 cattle or something. And then they can make cheese too. And they don't even need much to make cheese. We can also make butter. They can have a butter churner. There you go, butter, cheese, pears and apples. They can even have orchards. But the problem is... Can they handle more than this? Some resource sold out. Yeah, it was the wood. The wood I gave him. We could give him a bit more. I mean, we get the money, so... That's fine. The only problem is we cannot buy something from them. If we want their goods and we don't want to wait for the next taxation, which will come at the first day of the next season, and every season has 10 days or something, I think. But if we want that, we need to seize everything. Everything they have, which is not the best. We have a mining family. Oh, that's interesting. The problem is we don't even have some food set up right now. But we could already start mining. The thing is, how would they make money? We don't have a mason. We don't have anything. They are four people though, which is nice. They wouldn't make any money so far. It's impossible for them to make money. I think a fisher or something would be more important right now. I don't think I'll take those. But a big family can be good. Can also be very bad, but, you know. And we need to go on mining here. On a mining spree, actually. We can also designate the zone for now. Mining field, there it is. And just give him... Give some designation in here. Another resource sold out. It's probably the wood again. Just ignore that for now. Don't even know where I should put them. The building. Well, let's designate this a zone to be mined away. It's not given to any family or something, so it's not important. It's just there. Just planning ahead. So we're waiting for some families, we're waiting for them to get some work done here. Of course, the family that produces wood is quickest in building their own home. I am curious why we don't, because we have the wood, we have wood here. Wooden rods, yeah, they are a problem. Wooden rods are quite a problem. I don't even know how you make them. New family, masons. Well, that's great, thanks. I didn't take the miners, so why would I take the masons now? I don't even know if there is a building that makes wooden rods or helps with it or something. I think they just gather them. We could make them plant some trees. Cost nothing, but we can designate some. So they would do that on their own anyway. But just to give him some work in planting already, so we don't run out. They should gather some fruits here too, if they find them. But it's just spring, I don't think there will be much. Maybe in summer. Yeah, they're making some trees. There's some wood lying around. The problem is they're just not a lot of people here. Gary is not doing much, and I'm curious. Yeah, you're probably just starved for rods. You could look at this. How about our rods? Yeah, we don't have any. That's the thing. We could seize some from the Fox family. Let's seize eight wood rods. Thank you. That means we cut into our 30% because they store them, I think. Don't think we get them in the 30% anymore. But now we can finally start in building our own manor. Which I like. We will have a good stone industry. I don't think the rocks are only one layer. There are not many. There are not Z layers in the game so far as I know. So if we mine those things out, the miners will be useless. Never seen that so far, but it could happen. We are getting some food. Unfortunately, the wildlife is trying to eat it too. Like the chickens here. We could make them farm some chickens, maybe some pigs, if we want to. Yeah, when the barley is in, yes. That'll be some work there. And they're threshing already, that's good. Storing some straw, which is great. Hey, Bernie, welcome. I enjoy this game very much. It's so much fun just to do the logistical aspect, not worrying about some combat stuff or something. And just enjoying this. It's really cool. Yeah, you need rods too. Maybe I should have gone for straw housing. We could have. Wattle walls are just wood rods and straw. Cob walls are wood rods, and hay walls would just be straw. There's even stone walls, limestone, bricks. Oh, we can burn bricks later. Nice. We need to build a wall. A wall against what? Against the animals, maybe, yeah. So there's another family of miners. I guess. Let's just take him in. And we'll probably... I would like to use this as farmland later, maybe. There's more farmland here. And here, so it's fine, I guess. Let's just put him up here. The mining family can be up here too. You don't need to make the household, by the way. You can, for the baker, for example, you can just make a bakery. Is what the what do I want zones is what the tutorial teaches someone, but there's a big problem with that. I have seen. Let's just put you right next. You could be in the forest, just be next to the mountain. You have a lot of people, so you need a little bit more space. 8x8, 9x9. Let's make you a 9x9 too. So you can have some bigger rooms here. 7x7 and 7x7. It's actually as big as the manor, but you know. There are a lot of people there. Maybe? Maybe that's too much. Ah, it'll be fine. It's okay. Therefore, though, you will... problem is... They won't be able to actually pay me that much, but it's fine. This will go to the Mantell family, which we will rename right now. So, how should we name them? By the way, Mantell family, you give me... let's say 40% of what you make? Yeah, you give me a little bit more. That's fine. It's my mountains. This looks like a cross between RimWorld and Stardew Valley. Kind of. Me? The Bernie family? Bernie will be the miners? I mean, okay. We will make it the Bear family. We make them the Bear family, and the head of the family will be Bernie. You. Oh, you're very old already. Ooh. No, these are not married couples. Okay, so they're not married yet? Okay. What? No? Why no? You have fallen right into my trap? Gary, you misunderstood as always. I was greeting Mir. Why are you using the H then? That doesn't make any sense. M-E-H? Okay, well then not Bernie. Who else? Who else is in chat? Who can we make into a miner? Yeah, let's make Manaway into miner into the miner family, and maybe not the old one. This is a male. Oh, you only have males. Okay, Manaway, you're a little bit older. I hope that's fine. Or you just. You know what? No. What? No. Not this. We'll just make the family the Manaway family. I think that's fine. Not the Gamerids. The Mantells. There you go. The Manaways. There you are. But I wanted to be a librarian. There is no librarian, I'm sorry. Peasants work. Peasants do not think. That's not what peasants do. We need to give them something more. A bit more land here. Because... There it is. They need some storage space. And there is your ground storage. Yeah, I guess make two rows for now. That should be fine. We can also give him some walls and stuff. It'll be quite harsh to get them enough wooden rods for all the walls and us too. But it's fine. We'll manage, I think. As long as we can get them some beds, that should be okay. Get him some wooden doors. I guess here one, there and there. And just some beds. A double bed in here. And some straw bedding there for the moment until they get more children. Insufficient storages, yes, I know. If they wouldn't just drop stone somewhere and build their storages, it would be way better, but okay. Kinda like Mir. Not me, like you said. I thought you just, you know, artistic license and stuff, and Cell's chat has used it to greet him for weeks now. Well, I wasn't there much because Cell is streaming at an hour that is ungodly for anyone in Europe, so I have no idea that you do this there. And the mirror is spelled with an H because Cell turned it into an inside joke, okay? Yeah, see, inside jokes are a problem if you're not in. And since I'm not, I'm sorry, I misunderstood. Anyway, our mining family is going to mine like crazy now. That's good. How it should be. So we'll get some stone soon. So maybe we'll just plan for stone. We don't need wood. Oh, some loving going on in a second. We could do normal stone walls. We can't do brick yet. Can we do stone? Just upgrade this outright. Should mean we don't care about the other stuff and can just go for stone. I mean, not that we buy it from them. Maybe we can give them some stone homes. That would actually be pretty great because they will get stone like crazy. We could do limestone too, but... We need to make blocks. Do they? Oh, we need to make blocks. That means we need a mason first to do this. Ah, well, I guess it's fine for the moment. Let's just wait for this. That means they can't use stone either. The mason can. But the stone needs to be processed into blocks. So next time we get a mason, we really need to take him. And I probably put him up here. Maybe here. Ah, they will run out of meals. Yeah, we need to give everyone the ability to make meals, I think, very soon. Let's plan for this. Oh, well, get it started. Bone making workshop. Oh. You can probably send some soldiers towards the... Or maybe just weapons towards the king later. But yeah. So, to make meals, you need a cooking table. Because there you prepare the food. Then you need a cauldron. Let's put the cooking table somewhere else. There. A cauldron to cook the food. And a... Where is it? Oh, it would be so good if we had fish. We need something else. We need a well. Let's just use this public well for that. So we don't need as much stone. Oh, a wooden block. That's what we need. We need a wooden block to chop firewood. Which would make it great for the Royal Forest guys, for the Fox family, because they will sell wood like you wouldn't believe. Let's just put the chopping block here and extend their zone for now. There you go. That's fine. Could give him... We should give him more ground storage then. Let's put some ground storage here. And we need to replicate that for everyone. For us too. But I think we will get our own well. Because, I mean, we deserve it, of course. Certainly. We don't want to drink from the peasant's well, I mean. Come on. That's where they go with their filthy hands. There you go. And give me some ground storages too. We need some anyway. We'll probably need some barrels and stuff too. Oh, shelves. They need a shelf. And the shelf is for storing the meals. And they can also get some wooden tables. Guess let's put it here. Should, looks fine, yes. Maybe here? I think that's even better. Give him a table, give him... two wooden benches, and then they can sit and eat, and they'll be happy. Need to do that same stuff for us, but in a second. First, we need some... Can I click in here? Yes, cooking table. Same stuff as the others. Put it... no. There, no. There, please. Give me some... Yeah, they need barrels too. A wooden chopping block. I mean, I guess we could just put it here. Let's put it here, it's fine. And no tanning right now. We could give them storefronts in their work areas and they would just sell it from there, but why? We have a market, that's way better. It would be closer to them if they had that, but I don't think they need it. What else do we need? We need a cauldron, that's up there. And we need some... Let's put some ground storage here. We'll just give you a bit more space there. And anything else? The well, you have to access down there. It's a bit far away, but that's fine. I don't care. Give him some barrels and give him a shelf. That's it. Good. You guys, you have a lot of... Oh, you need some place to sit too. Wooden table. I mean, they're peasants. They don't need much. I don't want to block stuff, so I think this is the perfect place. Give him a bench. And another bench, and you are fine. Same thing down here. Cooking table. I like to put them in these crevices. Just looks better, I think, to have the cauldron here and the cooking table there than just next to each other. And... we need some shelves. Guess put the shelf there. Get some barrels here. Ground storage. Have some ground storage here and have the wooden block here. Later we have to put some ground in here so no trees are growing. Anything else? The well. You could have a well here. You could have a new public well up here, actually. And maybe we do that. Let's put a public well in here. Unfortunately, we have to build the public well, I think, because it's not owned by any of the peasants. So any public area is maintained by us. And our stone is used for this. But it's fine. Peasants will be happy. They have a well up here. Save some time. They have this stuff. You need to get a bit more zonage. There you go. And that should be fine. Now we need something to cook. Although we have all the meals anyway, so it's not that pressing. Cooking table. Next to the children, that's fine. They should burn, not us. There you go. Not that they exist yet. We have our own well. We have our chopping block. We built this stuff faster than God. Let's get some chests in the master bedroom. Of course. They could use some chests too, but at the moment, really don't care. And we don't... We want better stuff. Let's have a good wooden table for now. Oh, an expensive wooden table. With a gold ingot. Yeah, we can't do that, unfortunately. But we can get a good wooden table. Let's put it here. Let's put it here, actually. And there's a reason for that. Because this room is way too big. And we probably need a wall that holds up the roof. Anyway. Can we get a better bench or something? Let's get good wooden chairs. I like it. Oops. I don't like that you need separate buttons to get rid of a structure or of a plan. We have masons. Yes, we want you guys. We really need you, actually. And let's put them up here, too. Oh, but you had time to react to a certain post I made earlier at an equally ungodly hour? Yeah, well, I was up then, so yeah. Of course I did. Of course I did. We could build a separate house for you guys later. Let's put the masons here. So leave some space here to maybe extend these guys. How many people did the masons have? The Jensens? Oh my god, they have way too many people. Two married couples and some adults. Who's gonna be the masons? Gary the hypocrite. Why? It's not hypocritical. Just couldn't watch her lately. That's a lot of people. Let's put them... Yeah, let's put them here, and we need a big house too. For so many people. Two master bedrooms. 4, 8. This is 8, this is 9. By 4, 8, 9. There you go. And let's put you guys in here too. Okay, and we got some room to expand too. That's fine. Put in a wooden door. And some walls. Actually, you will have stone walls. Because you're the freaking masons. I mean, if anyone has stone walls but me, it's gonna be you. I like the sound effects. There you go. But of course, wooden doors. We are not dwarves, unfortunately. And you get a straw bed. There, you have the space. There. And I guess... some normal straw beds in here too. Room for some expansion. Oh, this room is bigger. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, we need to get rid of this. We can't give you more room. Come on. Again, you're peasants. It's not how you should live. Oh no, it was stone walls. There you go. Take something here. Okay, we'll resign them to the Jensens, which we need to rename, but you will pay me more. Because that is a big, big mansion there. You don't deserve that. Again, peasants. What is your work area? Actually, we could make this into a work area? No, I don't think so. There must be... What do they do? Masonry. Tailor's workshop, rope mill... There's the masonry. Workshop of the masoner to process stone materials. So it needs some stuff. Wooden blocks, ground stores, storefronts. That's it. So actually we could make that in front of this. Just put the mason area in here. Only nobles have surnames. PR something. They do? Could be, yeah. It's interesting to think about it. Pretty unfair, but interesting. Let's do that. Maybe let's get rid of these so they can access this a little bit better. It's too big. Let's give them some more. And let's put some wooden blocks in here. So they can work simultaneously. Since they are a lot of people. And actually some more ground storages maybe. They are four people, so I would like to have four wooden blocks in here, actually. And then have maybe a bit more ground storage. This is literally all they do. It's just cutting blocks. But that means we get blocks and we can build our house out of stone. Should we build it out of limestone then? Because we're special. Is limestone better? Not quite sure. There's some limestone they are mining here. The iron ore we can't use at the moment. Insufficient storages, that'll change. Yeah, I think we'll make our house out of limestone then. Just because we are special. We'll make it out of brick. Later, I guess. But since we have to wait anyway until we can build this out, if it's out of wood or out of anything else, we can make it out of limestone too. There you go, that will look fancy. Ah, look at this. We get some chairs and the first tax is coming very soon. How are you doing? Yeah, you know what? You can soon make meals, that's good. Actually, you can already make meals, that's really good. Just need to farm more stuff. I think we need more and the stupid animals are eating my crops. I don't like it. So, let's get more farmland in here. And let's get some animal farming in here. Actually, I need to move that. Let's do it this way and get rid of this. That should be enough farmland and we'll make a bigger farm here. It's not the best thing to do. I don't think if they can work. I don't think they can work this. Don't know if they do. Give me 30% as always. The Lieps. And you'll do some farming here. But you know, you will only farm no wheat, no barley. I'd like a button to clear this, to clear the priorities. You'll do some parsnips and you'll do some potatoes. I think that's fine. We need a big variety. And next season we have to check what is available at all in here. You don't have any barrels right now. Let's put some barrels in for you. Yeah. And I think you need some barrels here too. Maybe another threshing spot could be useful. A flailing spot, rather. There you go. So you can do that simultaneously. And there's something rotting already. That's not cool. Rotting on the fields. Let's make them finish this. And after they're done, we give them some animals. Maybe two cows, so they can make some cheese and some butter for us. Insufficient storage. Where? You guys. Another mining family. Yeah, no. They have some carrots and parsnips. That's good. You know what? You can't make some... No cabbages yet. Okay. So let's reduce the parsnips. And that will, in reducing the priority, will change the ratio they plant stuff in. Which is interesting. Okay, you really need some barrels. We have to check if someone is starving, because we have some normal meals we could grant them. Unfortunately, we can't sell them. We can't sell them normal. We can't sell them any meals for some reason. We can just grant them. And we cannot buy anything from them, which is also... kinda restrictive and strange, but of course makes it more important that you get the taxes at the end of the season and use them well. And think about what you're doing with this. Okay, there's nothing in these chests, probably because we have something here. We will of course rework the warehouse at some point. But yeah, let's put a cut in here for this part. I'll make some hourly videos for this, just one or two more, I think. We'll see. See you next time, everyone. Bye-bye.